our family had been waiting very eagerly for VJ Day because our father was a prisoner in the Far East. So I joined with all the crowds going up to the palace, and I think we stayed up late in the evening with fireworks and things. And, you know, it was a tremendous, great celebration for families like ours. So we were all waiting at home, and this car arrived. Our father, who we hadn't seen for 3 or 4 years, and his escort, and it was, you know, quite a wonderful moment. He didn't want to dwell too much about what he'd gone through in the last few years. He didn't really talk unless we asked him about the camp, and we realized it was all rather sensitive. He'd written up a diary on Sundays and Wednesdays in tiny little notebooks that he could hide in a hollow bamboo pole, and that got risky, and he buried the sections of it in one of the graves in their cemetery. So he kept the diary absolutely secret, which he had to because they weren't allowed to keep it, but in order to bring back a record, particularly of how the Japanese treated the prisoners, because he realized if he survived, there could be war crime trials, and this would be a rather rare bit of evidence.
I remember coming back to the house, the family house, one day when he'd been trying to get this printed, and he was standing halfway up the staircase holding all his documents in his hand. He looked down at me and he said, "They don't want it." And it took him a long time before anybody was interested in printing his report on what had been done in the camps out there.
His account of life in the camp is very interesting because I've read it, but you know, it was an awful time for all these men. I think the war opened up a lot of chances for women to drive and do jobs like our interception work that hadn't been known before the war. And, you know, I think a career in the women's forces is a very good career. It is really quite amazing that it was 75 years ago. I think that there was something very inspiring in feeling we were all in an effort with all the other people in the country, which doesn't really happen in peacetime.
Yes, I think there was also a feeling that there was a conscious evil about what was happening in the war. We didn't blame individual people so much, but there was a feeling this has got to be stopped. We cannot have this sort of relationship with other human beings, and somehow this must be prevented from ever happening again. I didn't know what sort of contribution we made, but it was worth trying to get this sorted out and stopped, and didn't let's have another war.